Thank you for watching, and in this video we are going to cover how we can add balloons into assembly drawing. So as in the previous video, we already added our bill of material. So now the next logical step is how we can add balloons to our drawing. So what I'm gonna do is, like, I'm just gonna select this exploded view, and then I'm gonna go into the annotations here and into the ribbon section, as we already covered balloons and auto balloon. So I'm gonna go into the balloons, and then after balloon, so I'm gonna go back into the exploded area, and then I'm gonna click, and as soon as I'm just gonna marking these parts, and then when I'm gonna insert them here, so as you can see, like, automatic numbering is gonna be inserted here according to my bill of material, suppose like this. So in that way, like, what I can do is I can explain all of my parts by balloon. So it's gonna explain. So in that way, like, this is really easy to understand, because we already have a bill of material who is gonna explain all about the part. So in this way, by using the balloons, we can just mention what part exactly belongs from which place. So that's why we are using balloons. So there is another thing, like, if you think whenever you are creating balloons, so the one option is, like, you can just have them in a nice look by moving them quickly from here to here, or if you want to bring them in one direction, or if you want to change the direction. So you can do, one option is you can do it manually, or there is another option, into the annotation you can see there is an option, magnetic line. So if I'm gonna draw a magnetic line here, and then as you can see, like, if I'm gonna go close to balloons, so all the balloons are gonna attach to my magnetic lines, and then by using this magnetic lines, I can align them, I can control them. Suppose I want to have magnetic line here, and I want the all balloons to be here. So maybe if I would like to change some of the balloons location like this, suppose I want to move it here, or you can move this one here as well. So in that way, what I can do is I can control all of my balloons, and they would look really nice. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you. Okay, so the next option is, if I'm gonna delete all of them, I just select all of the balloons, and then I just hit delete key on my keyboard. So there is another option, like, if I'm gonna go again, I'm gonna go into this exploded view, and then into the annotation. So you can see there is another option, which is auto balloons. So if I'm gonna click auto balloons, so it's gonna make all the balloons according to my bill of material table. So here, as you can see, like, it's gonna insert all the possible balloons, or all the possible items which we have in our assembly here, 7 items. So that's why here we have 7 balloons, as you can see. So again, what I can do is I can just move them one by one, or I can use a magnetic line. So in that way, I can control the motion and position of the balloons. So as in this part, like, we did not have a lot of parts, like, it was just only 7 parts, but if we have 20, 30 or 40 parts, so if we are gonna use the auto balloon, so it's gonna bring a couple of dozens of balloons in a different manner. So in that way, like, you need to spend some time to clean the drawing. So, like, if you are in hurry, so I would recommend you should use auto balloons, otherwise you can use all the balloons manually. So, and there is one more option I would like to mention here, like, suppose first I would like to go back into this assembly. So if I'm gonna select this exploded, and then I'm gonna go back into the assembly, okay, and suppose if you want to hide some part from the bill of material, so what you can do is, suppose I don't want to add any of part into the my bill of material, so if the part is not in the bill of material, so it's not gonna be into the balloons. So for that, what I can do is I can just go for any part. Suppose I want to hide this, so what I can do is I can right click on that, and then I can go here into the component properties, And then into the component properties, so you can see there is an option exclude from bill of material. So in that way, I can exclude any part, or if you want to hide any part which you don't want to show into the bill of material, so you can exclude it from the bill of part, and then you can select OK. So now I'm gonna go back. Okay, so after adding the balloon and the description here into the bill of material, which I already explained in the previous video, so what we can do is, like, we can see we can make a nice looking drawing, and then our drawing is ready, so we can send anywhere wherever we want. So in this way we can create our drawings from our assembly. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.